The communities of America come in all shapes and sizes, from small towns to sprawling cities. Regardless of size, rural and urban areas face similar challenges, from environmental, economic, and social issues to housing, development, and transportation. How can society address these often conflicting needs? At the University of Iowa's graduate program in urban and regional planning, students become practitioners in a field centrally concerned with enhancing the quality of life for all communities. The practice of planning integrates work in many disciplines to improve the natural, built, economic, and social environments of communities. Today's planners are concerned not only with urban growth and land use, but geographic information systems, transportation, environmental planning, and housing and community development. Professor Jerry Anthony focuses on the issue of housing and the societal impact of high housing costs in America.
The decade of the 1990s, 1990 to 2000, was a decade of phenomenal economic prosperity. And so you would expect that housing would become more affordable. Yet, if you look at the numbers, if you look at census data, in 1990, about 30% of the population paid too much for housing. And in 2000, 10 years later, after all this economic prosperity, 30% of the population still paid too much for housing. So in spite of economic prosperity, housing costs were very high.
Other facets of planning address our interaction with and impact on the natural environment. Professor Lucy Laurian focuses on environmental planning, a relevant topic in the agricultural state of Iowa.
I think it provides for a very unique perspective on the breadbasket, the center of this, the country. What Iowa faces in terms of water quality issues, agriculture, flooding, is not very different from other Midwestern states. But what we're doing here is actually central to long-term environmental quality and the productivity of the country.
From housing and environmental planning to economic development and transportation, all of these issues highlight the multifaceted nature of planning.
Planning is entirely interdisciplinary. So you can be an expert in housing, but you have to recognize the extent to which housing and transportation and economic development and community development all meet at the place that people actually exist and live and work.
Like the rest of the U.S., the state of Iowa has many small communities. They face the same problems as cities, but on a different scale. Iowa's Urban and Regional Planning Program engages small towns in a unique service learning course called Field Problems in Planning, where students learn by doing.
In a sense, the small towns that we have in Iowa provide an ideal place in which our students can touch base with the community. Trying these things out in small towns gives them a chance to work on problems at issue at a scale that are appropriate to somebody that's basically a rookie in the business of becoming a planner.
Iowa students haven't had to leave the campus for firsthand experience. The flood of 2008 profoundly affected the University of Iowa community, but yielded valuable lessons for those in the business of planning.
The flood was a pretty big thing, but I think it's provided an opportunity to do some really good urban planning intervention. Flood mitigation planning has to be most central to land use development.
The flood also illustrated vividly the regional aspect of urban and regional planning.
The only way we can solve the problems associated with our water basin, the Cedar and the Iowa River water basins, is by adopting regional solutions. And so for our students to see that and to experience it helps them to better understand the importance of regional planning.
Including flood mitigation in land use planning is one part of an increasing emphasis on overall sustainability.
Planning intervention is based on the notions of efficiency, environment, and equity. So sustainability is the underlying theme of the urban planning profession.
Value is a value, and you've got nothing on the land, right? So to get the market value of the land.
What a good planner does is recognize that places aren't just structures, and they're not just mortar and brick. They're people, and they're the neighborhoods and the communities that are formed in those places.
To learn more about urban and regional planning in Iowa, visit urban.uiowa.edu. Coming up, can you own a sound? Copyrights versus creativity.